Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Civil Graphics, and in today's video I'll be showing you how to design a school banner using CorelDraw. So if this is your first time here, kindly hit the subscribe button and don't forget to turn on notifications so you don't miss any of my tutorials. So right, let's jump right into this video. I'm here in CorelDraw X7, and this basically works for any version of CorelDraw, CorelDraw 2017, CorelDraw 2018, any version of CorelDraw. So right here, the design size is in inches, right? Because we are dealing with CorelDraw and want to export this in a very high resolution. So our design size here is 20.625 by 7.5. That is approximately 1980 pixels by 720 pixels. So now to create a borderline around this rectangular shape, I'm going to double click on the rectangle tool. This will give us an outline for the shape here. Now, let us take this by the side. Now we'll take our rectangle tool and we want to create a shape. So let's create a shape. So once we've created our shape, we're going to power clip it inside our design space. So right here, we're going to convert this curve and we're going to create a shape here. Now go to shape 2, right click on this and convert to curve. Now right here at the center, you just double click on this, then right click here and convert to curve. So let us create a shape. Also here, convert to curve, you right click and convert to curve. Then we drag this down. And so as you can see here, there's a node here. Now let us double click on it. Okay, to do that we are going to double click around here. So we want to create a node just like we have here. Double click here at the point and double click here. Now we cannot double click here to remove this. So you can see the shape here we've created. So we can use the arrows to adjust how we want the shape to move. Okay, right now, to create this effect, now let's make this longer. Now, I said this, we're going to power clip this image right here in our design space. So this right here, let's reduce the size. We're going to power clip it inside our rectangular shape. So right click on it and power clip inside. So you power clip it inside. Now let's double click to edit power clip, or you can just click on it, then right click on it and go to edit power clip. Then take this shape right here. We can reduce the size. Now to beautify this, let us give this a color. Let's give this, let's say purple. All right, so right here we are going to give this color white, but before that we are not yet through with this shape. We still want to make some changes to this shape. So right here, let me zoom this a little bit. Right here, I'm going to remove this angle. You can see this straight line here forming with the curve right here. Now we want to make this side curved. So right now, to do that, you take your shape tool, or you just double click on the shape, and right here you create a node here. Double click to create a node and double click here. So you can see how this formed a curved shape. It formed an arc. Now we can now adjust this by dragging this with your control and drag this to the left. So once you know how to use this tool, you are just good to go. So now we'll adjust this for changes. Now let's take this and let us reduce the size a little bit and let us bring it here. Now once we finish, right click and finish editing this layer, we can see the shape created here. Now let us give this white color. Now finish editing, you can see this and it's looking great. Now we are not done with this, so instead of us to take the rectangle tool and create another shape, why not just duplicate this? So now right here, edit power clip and drag and right click, or you press Ctrl D on your keyboard to duplicate. Now we're going to change the position of this. To change the position, just go at the top right here and click on mirror vertically. So let me zoom this. Click on mirror vertically. So we bring this down a little bit and we click on mirror horizontally to change the size. Then we bring this here. Now let's check it out before we make changes. So you can see the shape created. Now let's edit this. Let us reduce the size. And right here, we'll take our shape tool, or you can just double click. Then at the angle, let's bring out these arrows and adjust this down a little bit. You can see that it's breaking. So you just take it gently and bring it down a little bit. Now right here, we can just double click on this to remove this part. Now we have this part. So let us stretch this out a little bit. Now right click and finish editing this level. Okay, so let us still make some changes here. Now right here, we're going to take this up a little bit and this, take it to the side. And this, bring it down a little bit. Now let's check this out. Okay, this still looks okay. And for this other shape, let us make some changes. So double click to bring out the shape tool, or you can just go to the tools here to bring. Then using the node, you use the node to control the arrows and giving it a shape. So right here, I can just double click on that to remove that. So just making some little changes. Let us take this in a little bit. Now right click and finish editing this. Alright. Now that we are done with that, let us add our text. So I'll take my text tool. Here we have school admission. Give it a white and let us use and increase the size. So we have school admission. Now right here, we can give this yellow. Now to reduce the height between the text, you can click on your text properties. So you go at the top of your screen. Let me zoom this. See the text properties. So if you can't find it there, you go to Windows and you go to Tool. So if you can't find it there, you go to Text and go to Text Properties. Where is it? Let's look for it. So this is Ctrl T, Text Properties. So right here, I'll click on this. Now let us reduce the height between the text. So right here, we reduce the line spacing. So we can see this line spacing. Now we'll reduce it. Let's take it down a little bit. Now let us check the changes. So you see, once we reduce it, changes are being made. For now, let us put this at 65. Then let us increase it. Now take your text tool also and type now open for registration. Let us type it here. So I'll save this. So you take your text to and type now open for registration. So we can go to text and change case to sentence case or title case. For this, I'll use title case. Then we'll give it white and let us give it italic. Increase the font size. Let's put this up here. Now open for registrations. Okay. Now we go to the other details. We have the year. Put this in cap lock, year 2023. So let's give it white and using the question font. For this, we use the luckiest guy font. That's the name of the font, the luckiest guy, I mean. So for this question font, so let's give it year 2023. Replace this year. Now for that, let us create a shape for it. So right now, once you take your shape tool, now to make the edges here curved or in form of an arc, so just click and drag a little bit. Now once you've done that, right click and convert curve. Now we're going to make a little bit of change. So right here, we will drag this and drag this. Here we'll give it just like drawing a shape out. Then drag this a little bit in. Then for the other side, we repeat the same procedure. Take this and drag this. Okay, this one looks too. From the node here, you drag a little bit. And using the arrows, let's create a node here, double click. And here, double click. So I think that's it. Then for here, we can make this edge curved well a little bit. Okay, so we're trying to create a shape here. Okay, so we drag that and this. Okay, I think this is okay. So this is the shape we've created. Now we'll place this here, then our text will be on top. So shift page up to place the text on top of the shape. So we'll give our shape the yellow, then give the hair the color. So increase the size here. To reduce the height, you can see that this is a little bit big. Now let us drag this in a little bit and drag this down a little bit. Now to remove the black outline, right click on the cross lines here to remove the outline. I see that the outline is gone. Now let's fit this to page. Now we've done that. Now let's move on to call to find out more. Call to find out more. So we have some numbers here. 0. Let's just put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Then we have call to find out more. For this, we are going to give it bold. Let's say area bold. And let's give it font size 50. Then call to find out more. We can change this, go to text, change case to sentence case. Now let us edit this shape we clipped inside the design. Right click and edit power clip. Now we take this up a little bit. Let's take it up a little bit. Now let's check this out. Okay, this still looks okay. Let's edit this and take this down a little bit. Using the arrows, we edit this. Now let's bring this down. Can drag this right out. Now let's check this out. Okay. Now we bring this right here and call to find out more. We'll place it here. So here will be for our icon. Now. So to import, you right click and import, or you just simply Ctrl I. Now we import this. Okay, let's use let's use this instead. And we place it here. Now for the background, we give it white, but you can see that once we click on this, you notice that the color does not apply. So what do? We go to trace bitmap, outline, trace, line art. Then we convert this to vector and we click on it. You can see now that the color applies. We have our link right here. So we're going to right click and we're going to break curve apart. Once we break curve apart, select that link itself, shift, page up, and give it purple. So, and we have that, then you can select both and Control G to group. So we have them grouped together. Then take your text and let us type www.websitename. So your website name will appear here. So let's increase the size. Okay, for this, let's reduce the size, place it here. Now let's go to text, change case, let's put this in lowercase. Well, because of the font, we cannot put this in lowercase. So let's change the font, use Montserrat font instead. Yeah, and that fixes it. So let's give this bold, reduce the size, and let's give this 30. Now let's check this out. So we have our design and this is looking awesome. So there are still something we need to fix, like this part. Let us edit this. Let us add some background icons to this. Now here are some icons I downloaded, so let us import them. Like for this, now remember we can't apply color, we have to change this to vector. Then once we've changed it using the yellow, we can click on it and rotate it and reduce the size. Let's place this at the background. So we can place this here and rotate it a little bit. So right here, we can reduce this and just place it here. Okay, and that looks better. Now let us also import this. Now let us change this to line art and vector. Now place this here, give it the yellow. Right now let us add some icons to our background. So make them transparent. Now we import them. We can just select like this and import them. Now right here we can just decide to use transparency direct and give this 90. Now place it anywhere in the background. And this also use transparency to give it uniform transparency and give it 90. So I hope you can see my screen. So here we have transparency and we have this, so we give it 90. So I just want to show you that. Now for this we need to add it Let us reduce the size and let us remember that this background we're adding should be beneath the text. So shift page up for the text to place it. So let us make this curved a little bit. Now for the year 2023, now using your ruler, we can bring out the guideline and place everything horizontally and vertically. So we align them. So you make sure that all of them are aligned, so you can see that they are aligned. For the school admission, let us increase the height a little bit and call to find out more. We can give it Montserrat bold. Also this, we can give it Montserrat bold. Then we can use our guideline to make sure that this is properly aligned. Okay, now the thing remains. Now let's remove the outline of the shape. Now right click and edit power clip, remove this outline, click on the shape. So we select the shape and right click on the cross line by the side. So let me zoom this again. You right click on this to remove the shape. See, it's gone. And for this, you right click to remove the shape. And that's it. And right click to finish editing. So we have this, and let's not forget one more thing. Enroll now. Yes, we didn't add it. Let's quickly now for this enroll now, we are going to use the same background. So now let's drag and right click or Ctrl D to duplicate. So mirror vertically. So we are just going to be using the same background. For this, bring it like this and take this in a little bit. Let's just put this here and shift page up to bring it to the front. What font do we use here? Question font. So let us use the same font. And let us align it to the center. Now, for the text properties, we reduce the space of the high hand, the line spacing, and enroll now. We have this. Now we can just take this and quickly form a 2-year. Right click and convert curve. Then we have this, just place this right here, give it yellow and remove the outline. So let's reduce the size, so give it that filling. Now use your shape tool to just change the direction. So from the node you change direction, you click to change the direction. Now let's see how this looks like. Yeah, and roll now. Give it the purple color. Let's just try luckiest guy. Okay, seems the luckiest guy font fits in well. So let us increase the size. Okay, this looks too much. 30 should be okay. Quite much. 28. All right. Let us flip this. Okay, I think this looks way better. Now by the side, let us adjust it. Take your shape to, yeah, I think this looks, then we want to make this slanty, take it down a little bit and bring this down right here. Let us make this an arc. Now double click here, double click here. That will give us an arc, a curved edge. So I want to give it that feeling. Now we can reduce the size by this side, and this you can reduce it and take this in. So we have this enroll now. Let us Control G. Now bring in our design. Are going to place it on our design. Take this and place it here. So we have increased the size. Now let us rotate this a bit. Rotate this a bit. Yeah. Enroll now. And we have that. What is left for us to do here is to remove this black outline. You can see this black outline. To do that, same way we've done it for all, we right click here. So you can see that that black outline is gone. And we have our design right here. So we're going to group this together. So let us group it, or we can as well change this background. I have that Z to change this background. Okay, let's see this. Okay, this looks okay. We can as well change this here to deep violet. Sorry. On group objects, deep violet, giving it a feel. It's still okay, and this we can also change this. That's just it. You can give it any color you wish to. It still works for any. Just make sure that the text pops out, because you're trying to create an awareness. So right now we've come to the end of this tutorial. Now select all and Control G to group. So we've grouped them right now as one. So, and we have it. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe, like, comment and share, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much for watching.